So we have been doing this article. Some part already I have explained in the previous lecture. Let me recall it again. Yes. This one is an important article, Article 6.7 on page number 80 given in your book. See, actually, the, one of the disadvantage of this semester system is, you know, we have very limited time. A teacher cannot know in detail about topics. So the equation of conic. Equation to the conic. Say ax square plus 2hxy plus by square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So this is the expression, and when we equate equal to 0, we'll call it as conic. When the origin, is transferred to the center. So what observation we have made, let me revise that. We have seen that if that in from the earlier lecture, that if center is C, x dash y dash, which is solved, which will be obtained by actually on partial differentiating this equation with respect to x and y and equating it to zero, you will get this equation ax dash plus hy dash plus f equal to zero, and similarly hx dash plus by dash plus f equal to zero, ax dash plus hy dash plus g. And on solving, suppose center is this one. Now what we are doing, that if we shift its origin to the center, then basically this equation get transformed into, on shifting origin to center. So let me write here, on shifting origin to center, this equation transfer center x dash y dash, center x dash y dash, this equation and transform into this one, ax square, sorry. It will be a x square. Actually, while shifting, I am considering that we are shifting origin, keeping axis parallel to the initial axis. So if this one is x, this one is y, this is capital X and capital Y. So already I have explained this concept in the previous lecture. So after substituting that, we will get this equation, a x square plus 2h x y plus b y square plus c dash equal to zero. Some new constant c dash, and basically this constant c dash, we will see that this c dash will be equal to this one. C dash is equal to g x dash plus f y dash plus c. This one is the relation in terms of value g and c. So how after shifting, basically you will get this one, where c dash, actually this we will get on simplifying. After substituting this one, small x is equal to say x plus x dash, and y is equal to say y plus y dash. After doing this transformation, actually your original equation is in terms of small x, small y, and on doing this transformation, we will get equation in terms of capital X, capital Y, and c dash basically as this one. Basically, your c dash is ax dash whole square plus 2hx dash y dash plus b dash y square plus 2gx dash plus 2fy dash plus c equal to 0. And on simplifying this equation with respect to these two, you will get this equation. So this I have to remember. While solving question, we will apply this one. And in other terms, see how to obtain this. See, if we call this equation as, let us call this equation as 1, this one as 2. So what will happen, that multiply in this one by x dash, and thus in second one by y dash, and then add these two equation, and then using three is this one. Please mute your mic. This one you will get this equation gx dash plus fy dash plus c. So you can see that, see here the first term is ax dash, on multiplying x dash, you get the first term is ax dash whole square. Clearly, keep multiplying x dash in all these terms and then multiply y dash in all these terms, add them and then subtract from this equation. Then subtract from this equation. So you will notice that ax dash on multiplying this x dash by x dash, it will get cancelled out here. All these terms will cancel out and you will get this one. The new constant c dash is gx dash plus fy dash plus c, where g, f and c are known from the initial equation given to you, from the equation of conic given to you, and x dash, y dash are centers which is already known to us on solving this one. So that is what we are getting. Also, one can interpret in some different forms. See, from these two equations, I have this one. Let me write here ax dash plus hy dash plus g equal to 0, hx dash plus fy dash plus by dash plus f equal to 0. Let me write the third equation. Third equation as gx dash plus fy dash plus c minus c dash equal to 0. So you can see that we have a 3x3 system of linear equation, and for non trivial solution as above, I mean for eliminating x dash y dash, because in our question this a h b g f c, these are the known constant. So for after eliminating x dash y dash, so we know how to eliminate x dash y dash. For non-trivial solution of the system ax equal to 0, determinant of a has to be 0. We have already seen this concept earlier. So from there, what we will get? A, h, g, h, b, f, g. Let me write here f, c minus c dash. This determinant has to be 0 for non-trivial solution. Now, if you expand this determinant, you can write here 0, and just use the expansion of determinant. So from here, what we will get? We'll get a, b, c, f, g, h, and by symmetricity, right here, f plus the remaining term. Look here, a, h, g. This we have taken now, right? A, h, 0, h, b, 0, g, f, and minus c dash. So let me write here plus a, h, 0. H into B, H B 0, G F, and then C minus C dash equal to 0 on expanding the determinant. So let me call this whole term as delta, just for our sake of convenience. For convenience, let me call this whole determinant as delta. Obviously, determinant will give you a real number. So because all the here all coefficients are real, so delta is equal to delta plus. On expanding this around this, we will get C dash into AB minus H square is equal to 0. So from here, you will get C dash is equal to delta upon AB minus H square. So the new constant which we required, see, on this transformation in the equation of conic, this is the constant C, and on transformation, you will see that all linear term will not be there, and all these terms of degree 2 will be preserved with small x, small y change to capital X, capital Y. And we have a new constant here, C dash. And this C dash is determined by this equation. So either use this one, or you can use C dash as this formula. So you can, from both you can obtain C dash. So I will prefer this one. Okay, I will, while solving questions, I will prefer this one. So this is the technique. Now, based on this, let us do one more question. So there is a question number 2 on page number 81. Show that the equation of the conic x square minus 5xy plus y square plus 8x minus 20y plus 15 equal to 0. Refer to parallel axis through this center. Is x square minus 5xy plus y square is equal to 1. So this is your question. So based on the previous article, you have to do this. So what are the steps we need to take? First of all, find its center first. Okay, so first part, see, whenever you need to apply this equation, look, transformation, so what we need? First, we need center, and we know how to obtain center. For center, we need to put del f by del x equal to 0 and del f by del y equal to 0. Okay, so first of all, simplify this. So for center, let me consider this equation as f. Okay, put del f by del x equal to 0 and del f by del y is equal to 0 and simplify. So what will be del f by del x equal to 0? It will be 2x minus, keep treat y as constant, 2x minus 5x, sorry, 5y, because I am differentiating partially with respect to x, plus 0 plus 8 plus 0 plus 0 is equal to 0. And second, while you are differentiating partially with respect to y, the first term will be 0, second term will be minus 5x plus 2y plus 0 minus 20, yes, is equal to 0. So simplify this, check what is your answer, solve kar iska dekhi kya answer aa raha hai, because once you know the center, you can use directly the transformation. चलिए सॉल्व करके बताएं कितना आया इसको. Check whether you are getting this point as center on solving. Simplify करके देख लें क्या आपको ये मिल रहा है. Minus 4 0. Let us check this one. So minus 8. If x is minus 4, so it will be minus 8. Plus 0.
Yes, sir.
Plus 8 equals 0, and the check whether it is satisfying or not, the second one. So,
yes, sir.
Okay, let me check 20 and minus 20. Yes, it's okay. So, now you have, this is what your x dash and y dash. This is what your x dash and y dash. Now, as per transformation, let me call this as equation number 1. Now, shifting origin to center. Means assuming your center as the origin now, minus 4 0, what will be this equation? Look, if you look at the previous article, then all this term has to be retained. See, the all two degree terms are retained. The only difference is that we need to replace this x by capital X and y by capital Y, and then this whole term should be replaced by c dash, and c dash is obtained by this equation. So that's what I'm going to apply directly, because already we have completed the article. So on shifting the origin, the new equation will be x square minus 5xy plus y square plus some constant c dash equal to 0. And as per rule, this c dash is basically gx dash plus fy dash plus c. So g and f, g is half of coefficient of x, 2gx. So 2gx, if you compare it, then 2gx is equal to 8x. So from there you will get g is equal to 4. So let me write 4 here. X dash, value of x dash is minus 4 plus f. F is basically 2y, 2fy. So compare, f is equal to minus 10. minus 10 into y dash. Y dash is 0 plus the constant c is 15. So on simplifying, look what we are getting: minus 16 plus 15 is equal to minus 1. Okay. Now replace right here minus 1. So your equation will be x square minus 5xy plus y square minus 1 equal to 0. Or you one can write x square minus 5xy plus y square is equal to 1. Now let me check. Yes, this one is the equation: x square minus 5xy plus y square equal to 1. ठीक है, समझ में आ गया आप लोगों को? एक क्वेश्चन मैंने दो क्वेश्चन सॉल्व कर दिखा दिए कैसे करना है आपको। अब एक्चुअल में देखो, इन चीजों को तो बहुत डिटेल में पढ़ाया जा सकता है, लेकिन सेमेस्टर सिस्टम में सबसे बड़ी दिक्कत क्या है ना कि बहुत लिमिटेड क्लासेस है, मतलब 40 क्लासेस में कंप्लीट करना है, आपका सिलेबस इतना ज्यादा है। दिस इज द मेन ड्रॉबैक इन आप सेमेस्टर सिस्टम। ठीक है, तो चलो मैं कुछ एक्स्ट्रा क्लास रिकॉर्ड करके भी दे दूंगा आपको। अब कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक मैं इग्नोर नहीं कर सकता, और ऐसे हालात में क्योंकि आपका बैच बहुत लेट शुरू हुआ है, मुझे लग रहा है 23 मार्च को शायद मैंने पहला क्लास लिया है, और अब तक टोटल 22 है, क्योंकि 42 लेक्चर्स हैं वीक में, तो अभी हम लोग 6th वीक में हैं। और सही बताऊं तो ये आपका कोर्स जो है मिनिमम 48 लेक्चर्स का है। थोड़ा सा मैं कहीं फास्ट रहूँगा, तो द नेक्स्ट आर्टिकल इज locus of middle point of system of parallel chords. Take this article as, do it by yourself, take it, this one as home assignment. Locus of, it's given on page number 81, read it, and if you have any doubt you can discuss. That is locus of the middle points of a system of parallel chords. So you will see that the required locus is again a straight line. Basically, suppose you have ellipse or and you have the system of parallel chords, there, and suppose this one is their middle points, then on joining you will get again a straight line. So how to write equation of this one? So the idea behind this one is, so see, for the general conic is equal to zero, we already know that suppose all these chords are parallel to y equal to mx. Suppose all these chords, because we need a system of parallel chords, so suppose all chords are parallel to y is equal to mx. Okay. Suppose these are the chords, and if x dash y dash, basically if x dash y dash is their middle points. So we know in earlier lecture I have already proved that chord of a given middle point t equal to s1 is given by this equation: a x dash plus h y dash plus g times x minus x dash plus h x dash plus b y dash plus f into y minus y dash is equal to 0. Okay, now the slope of the chords must be equal to m. Actually, slope of this chord, okay, let us find the slope of this chord. So you can see that the slope of this chord is basically, actually all these chords are parallel to y equal to mx. So if you let us take any one chord, and suppose its middle point is x dash y dash, then you can write here t equal to s1 basically, and slope of this chord is basically what is m, because all chords are parallel, so have the same slope. So from here one can obtain that m is equal to minus, if you simplify, x dash plus h y dash coefficient of y upon coefficient of x. So you will get this one: h x dash plus b y dash plus f. This one. So on cross multiply required locus, actually you need to find locus of middle point, I mean x dash y dash. So finally you need to replace x dash by x and y dash by y. So required locus will be, therefore the straight line on multiplying, you will get basically ax dash plus hx dash plus g into say plus m times hx dash plus py dash plus f equal to 0, and for locus of x dash, y xy, locus of middle point, we need to replace finally x dash by x and y dash by. So we will get this one, ax plus hx plus g plus m times hx plus by plus f equal to 0. So you can clearly see that this passes through the point of intersection of the line. Basically, if you remember, then L1 plus lambda L2 equal to 0. Suppose we have L1 equal to 0 and L2 equal to 0. Then the point of intersection, I mean, this one is given by family of lines passing through this point of intersection is given by L1 plus lambda L2 equal to 0. And that is obtained by solving L1 equal to 0 and L2 equal to 0 separately. So this is what, this is L1 plus, if you call this as a real number lambda, L1 plus lambda L2 equal to 0. So for that, this has to be 0. So this passes through the point of intersection of the lines ax plus hy plus g equal to 0 and hx plus by plus f equal to 0, which is the center of the given cone. Already we have proved that. So we have proved this one. So required locus will be, and you can see that this one is a linear in x and y. So it is going to represent a line. Okay. So this is what. Now next topic is conjugate diameter. So I have explained this one. This is already given in your book. You can do it. Now next article. This one is an important concept, conjugate diameters. Conjugate diameters. So as per definition of conjugate diameter, let me write its definition first. The locus of the middle point of a system of parallel chords of a conic is called diameter. And two diameters are said to be equal conjugate when each bisect chords of the conic parallel to other. When each bisects chords of the conic parallel to other. So look at the definition here. Locus of middle points of a system of parallel chords is called the diameter. So that is, again, you are going to have a straight line, just like in the previous example we have seen. And those two lines, I mean, you can say two lines passing having middle point. So two such diameters are said to be conjugate if when each bisects chords of the conic parallel to other. Bisect word is there, not perpendicular. For example, suppose we have this ellipse and we have system of parallel chords here. So on joining their middle point, you will get one of the chords, a diameter, as per definition. This one is the diameter. For this system of parallel chords, this one is the diameter. Now, so as per definition, the locus of middle point, of system of parallel chords is called diameter. First part completed. Now two diameters are said to be conjugate when each bisect chords of the conic parallel to other. So for this system of parallel chords, if this one is the diameter, and suppose parallel to this, suppose there are parallel chords, and two diameters are said to be conjugate when each bisect chords of the conic parallel to other. Now, if say this one, okay. Suppose again we have system of parallel chords. This is system of parallel chords, and if we join their midpoint, if we join their midpoint, then let me make it some with some different color. Then I suppose this one. Then my claim is that these two lines. And this one will be said as to be conjugate diameter, say d1 and d2, d2 equal to 0 and d1 equal to 0, are said to be conjugate diameter when each bisect chords of the conic parallel to other. What bisect means? It will divide into two equal halves. See, this chord is dividing, this diameter is dividing this chord into two equal parts. So nowhere it's written that, I mean, these conjugate diameters may be perpendicular, may not be perpendicular. In case of circle, you will see that they become perpendicular, but in case of other conic, it may not be perpendicular. So you need to be careful. In definition, bisect word is there. So now let us try to obtain the condition under which two diameters passing through, two diameters are said are conjugate. So suppose, okay. And look at the previous result. If you simplify this one, then you can see that equation of y equal to mx. So we need system of parallel chords y equal to mx, and then so we have seen in the preceding article that a diameter of a central conic passes through its center. If you look at the previous, then from here this one is very clear, because see, actually this x dash y dash is obtained by solving these two equations. If you recall, then ax dash plus hy dash plus g equal to 0 and hx dash, hx dash plus by dash plus g equal to 0. So this one is very clear that locus of middle point of system of parallel chords, it always passes through the center. Center is x dash y dash. So using this article, what I am going to say, suppose let the diameter drawn parallel to y equal to m dash x. Drawn parallel to y is equal to m dash x, bisects all chords of the conic. Of the conic s equal to 0, which are parallel to y equal to mx. The equation of diameter from the previous article, if you look at the equation of the diameter from the previous article, this one, look, equation of diameter is given by this one. I mean, locus of the middle point of system of parallel chords, that is what your diameter. So equation of diameter from the previous article is given by ax plus hy plus g, the same times hx plus by plus f equal to 0. So compute coefficient of x from here. So on computing coefficient, we will get a plus hm plus y times h plus bm into g. Yes, plus g, there is no term, yes, g plus fm, f into m is equal to 0. So these two are constant terms. And these are coefficient of x and y. And since by hypothesis, see, we have assumed that these are supposed system of parallel chords y equal to mx, and this will come as diameter after joining their middle point. As per definition of conjugate diameter, this one will be parallel to this one. I mean, y equal to m dash x, slope of this line will be parallel to y equal to m dash x. Y equal to m dash x. So try to find its slope of this line and write it as m dash x. So what I am going to do here, that From this, the slope m dash is equal to a plus hm upon h plus b into m. Here, from this, because coefficient of y is h plus bm and this one is a plus hm, so slope will be basically coefficient of x. I mean, so y, if you write into this standard form y equal to mx plus c, then this m will give you slope. So writing in the standard form, you'll get minus times a plus hm upon h plus bm. Minus times, yeah, minus times a plus hm upon h plus bm. And also simplifying, you will get this equation a plus hm plus h plus bm plus m, sorry, into m dash equal to zero. And again, if you simplify this, you will get a plus h times sum of the slopes of both lines plus b times their product slope is equal to zero. So basically, this one is the required condition. Suppose those two lines, I mean diameters, are parallel to y equal to mx and y equal to m dash x. So for these two lines, I mean for those two lines drawn parallel to y equal to mx and y equal to m dash x, this one is the requirement. This one is the requirement. If this condition is satisfied, then those two diameters will become conjugate diameters. So based on this, there is an article, and you can look that they're just symmetry. Symmetry in relation. I mean, if you replace m by m dash in this equation, m dash, and so again you will get the same equation. So from the symmetry of this relation in m and m dash, we see that the same is the condition in order that the diameter parallel to y equal to mx may bisect chords parallel to y equal to m dash x. So if chords are given parallel to y equal to mx and y equal to m dash x and they are conjugate diameter, then condition will be same. So from here I can say that, hence the diameter y equal to mx and y is equal to, because these two are also lines, y is equal to m dash x are conjugate if a plus h times m plus m dash plus b into mm dash is equal to zero. So if you know the slopes, if you know the slopes of those two lines, then just find the slope of m plus m dash. Write here m plus m dash and put here the value of mm dash. AHB will be already given to you because the equation of conic will be given to you. So from there you can obtain this one and put it, and if this comes out to be zero, then these two diameters are said to be conjugate diameter. So this we have to check. So now remember here that m and m dash are coming from the, I mean, those two lines we are claiming as conjugate diameters. You need to simplify to find out the value of mm dash from that equation. And this a, h and b, these are coming from the equation of conic. So based on this, there is a question. Question number one, page 82. So find the condition. Find the condition that the lines ax square plus 2 hxy plus by square equal to 0 may be conjugate diameter, may be conjugate for the conic ax square plus 2hxy plus by square equal to 1. Now try to first understand this question. Look, this is always going to give you pair of straight line passing through origin. If you recall equation of this type, all the coefficients are of 2 degree, there is no linear constant term, it will always give you pair of straight line passing through origin. This will be your pair of straight lines passing through origin. Okay. Passing through origin. And this one is the, so remember that here the small a, h and b, this is coming from the equation of the conic, and capital A, h, b are terms involved in pair of straight lines passing through origin. Now if you recall here, then because directly equation is not given. I mean, here combined equation is given for pair of straight line. So from this equation, you need to find the slope m1, m2 of both two lines. And once you know that, because in this condition, you need to require this one, slope of sum of slopes and product of slope. So after comparing from this equation, you can find the sum of slopes and product of slope, put it into this equation. And remember, here is A, H and B. These are the coefficient coming from the equation of Kony. So already the same notation is here, so there will be no problem. So now let us compare it to let us find the slope of this line. So this one is a standard equation already there. Already I have solved that sum of roots m1 plus m2 is equal to minus 2h by b and m1 m dash is equal to a by b. Let me recall here that if you compare, because this is always going to give you the pair of straight line. So suppose those two lines represented by this equation are, suppose y is equal to mx and y equal to m dash x, b conjugate diameters. So you need to write their joint equation. In my other lectures already I explained you how to write their joint equation. You need to put it to zero and compare this equation with this one. So on comparing, you will get this one. Say sum of roots means slopes is equal to minus 2h by b and product of roots mm dash and product of slope is as a by b. So that already you know, this technique already I have explained earlier. I am not going to revise here. Now for condition for conjugate lines, for conjugate diameters, if you recall, then condition is a plus h times m plus m dash plus b times mm dash must be equal to zero. So let me write here that condition, that for conjugate diameters a plus h times sum of root, a plus h times sum of slopes. So sum of slope is minus 2h by b. So let me write here minus 2h by b plus and then plus b times their product, I mean a by b equal to zero. So you can multiply by b throughout this equation. So from here you will get a into b minus 2h, because minus sign is here, minus 2h by b, minus sign, therefore minus 2 small h into capital H plus b times a equal to 0. So this is the required condition. I mean, if this expression will hold, then the two lines passing through origin, pair of straight line passing through origin, they will be conjugate diameter to this conic if this condition is satisfied. ठीक है, दिस कंडीशन इज सेटिस्फाइड. तो देखो आर्टिकल चैप्टर 2 का जो थ्योरी सेक्शन था वो मैंने करा दिया. सॉल्व एग्जांपल 2 है, वो आप खुद से पढ़ लेंगे. एंड नाउ आई विल कम टू क्वेश्चंस ऑफ द फ्रॉम योर एक्सरसाइज. ओके, हियर आई सेड हियर दैट since I don't have much time, I am not going in detail, but here one of the important observation which I need to emphasize, that in this definition it is written that conjugate diameters will bisect chords of the conic parallel to other. So never, I mean, they may be perpendicular, they may not be perpendicular. So in the case of ellipse, if you look at the standard case of ellipse, or take anyone having this 0, x square by a square plus y square by b square equal to 1, and suppose this one is the slope of, so you can easily verify that mm dash is equal to minus b square by a square. I mean, in the case of a standard ellipse, x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Take parametric and coordinates here. This one is your origin 0, 0. So right slope of this line, right slope of this line. And you can verify that, actually, take any point on this one. So in that case, you will simplify, after simplifying, you will get mm dash equal to minus b square by a square. And if these two lines are perpendicular, then their product must be equal to minus 1. So now here, from here, you can see that if b is equal to a, I mean, if major axis and minor axis coincides, then in that case, you will get your, you will get circle. So in case of circle, conjugate diameters will be perpendicular. But in general, they may not be perpendicular. So this is the misconception that conjugate diameters will be perpendicular. So this is not true. In general, this is not true. I don't have time. Otherwise, I will explain that if you, keeping I mean you can draw this what to say auxiliary circle, I mean taking this one its major axis as diameter, you can take this one. And now when you draw perpendicular from this one, I mean take any point on this circle denoted by a cos phi and a cos theta b sin theta, take its projection on this one, then you will get the coordinates of here. I mean so you can see that the after taking projection x axis will remain same, but this y axis will change, so in general from there you can verify that conjugate diameters I mean may not be equal. I mean writing the general equation of these coordinates, you can write that mm dash is equal to minus b square by a square. So if I get time I will explain this, but in your calculus portion look where you are computing radius of curvature and all that in your calculus syllabus, I have seen that this is already there. So I am not here going to remark this one, but in general remember that conjugate diameters need not be perpendicular to each other. So this is what observation. You can prove that mathematically. Just I have given here hint that you can verify that. Now you need to solve. From your exercise, try question number 3. Because some questions are parallel, you know, on page number 83, try this question. Question number 3, 4, 6. You will find variation in each of these question. Question number 8, 11, 12, and 15. Try these questions from your book. Try this one. After completing these questions, your chapter 2 will be finished. One article is left. I mean, on transferring rotating equation of, I mean, by what angle we will rotate the axis so that the xy terms get removed from the equation of conic. So that article I have not explained. I think I have 5 to 10 minutes. Let me explain that one, because to start some questions are time taking. Therefore, I need to start in a new class. The concept of invariant I forget to explain, so that I will cover in the next lecture. ठीक है, तो आपको आज conjugate diameter मैंने करा दिया. अब देखो क्या क्या इसमें article मैंने कराया. मैंने आपको conjugate diameter condition करा दिया, equation of the conic when origin is transferred to the center, ये article करा दिया. और इससे पहले हमें center का equation कैसे निकालेंगे उसका तरीका बता दिया. व्हाट वी मीन बाय कंजुगेट पॉइंट्स एंड कंजुगेट लाइंस. सी कंजुगेट लाइंस इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग, कंजुगेट डायमीटर इज डिफरेंट. कंफ्यूज नहीं होना है ना. कंजुगेट पॉइंट्स एंड कंजुगेट लाइंस आर द कांसेप्ट इन्वॉल्विंग पोल एंड पोलर. कंजुगेट पॉइंट्स और कंजुगेट लाइंस का जो कांसेप्ट है वो पोल और पोलर को इन्वॉल्व करते हैं. ठीक है, तो और उससे पहले मैंने क्या पढ़ा दिया आपको, पोल पोलर का पेयर यूनिक. आई मीन अंडर व्हाट कंडीशन पोलर विल बी बिकम टेंजेंट, ऑल दैट कंडीशन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड. तो आर्टिकल 2 तो हो गया. इससे पहले पेयर ऑफ टेंजेंट्स फॉर अ गिवन पॉइंट, इसका आर्टिकल भी आपको डिराइव करा दिया है. टेंजेंट का इक्वेशन कैसे डिराइव होगा, पेयर ऑफ टेंजेंट का इक्वेशन कैसे डिराइव होगा, कॉर्ड विद अ गिवन मिडिल पॉइंट इक्वल टू s1 वो कैसे डिराइव होगा, कॉर्ड ऑफ कांटेक्ट ऑफ टेंजेंट का इक्वेशन कैसे लिखेंगे, तो ये सारे प्रूफ मैंने कवर कर दिए. ठीक है, अब आते हैं कुछ न्यूमेरिकल पोर्शन पे. आई मीन फ्रॉम नेक्स्ट क्लास आई विल एम्फसाइज ऑन न्यूमेरिकल पोर्शन. और ऐसा करेंगे, अभी तो मैं डिटेल में करा रहा हूं. Because there is in last unit, fourth unit, there is one very new, you can say for you people, is a polar इक्वेशन ऑफ अ कोनिक। तो मैं उस पर जोर ज्यादा दूंगा क्योंकि वो आपके लिए नया है और दैट आल्सो वी विल रिक्वायरिंग कैलकुलस एंड एडवांस कैलकुलस क्वेश्चन, ठीक है ना, पोलर इक्वेशन ऑफ अ कोनिक। और आफ्टर दिस देयर इज अ टर्म इन्वॉल्विंग सी ट्रेसिंग ऑफ कोनिक। देखो क्योंकि सेमेस्टर सिस्टम में टाइम कम है तो मैं आपको पैराबोला, एलिप्स, हाइपरबोला वगैरह का बेसिक नहीं बता रहा हूँ। ऑलरेडी आप 11th में पढ़े हो, अगर टाइम होता तो मैं वहां पे भी करा देता क्योंकि लिमिटेशंस हैं और हम लोगों ने इस बार सिलेबस में पढ़ाया ही चीजें, तो आप वो बेसिक चीजें खुद से पढ़ लें और अगर टाइम मिल गया तो लास्ट में हम इसे कर देंगे। लेकिन जो नई चीजें हैं जिसमें नया कॉन्सेप्ट इन्वॉल्व है उसको पहले प्रेफरेंस देते हैं, ठीक है ना। उसमें पोलर, एक तो ट्रेसिंग में भी आपने क्या देखा होगा, यहाँ मैं दो नए टेक्निक ट्रेसिंग में पढ़ाऊंगा। वो नए टेक्निक क्या है बेसिकली, देयर आर, व्हाइल स्टार्टिंग ट्रेसिंग आई विल एक्सप्लेन दैट इन देयर आर टू न्यू मेथड्स गिवन इन दिस, आई मीन कोनिक ट्रेसिंग। सी इन योर प्लस टू एग्जाम, इफ यू लुक एट मोस्ट ऑफ द बुक्स इन प्लस टू, देयर you will find that before, I mean, factorizing, suppose any equation is given, any general equation of conic is given, x, just I am trying to give you a general idea that why the coming two techniques are important. Suppose this conic is given, now this is all, if xy term is not there, then you can easily factorize. Suppose del is non-zero, I mean, apart from pair of straight line, if it represents any of the conic, I mean parabola, ellipse, hyperbola, parabola, ellipse, circle, hyperbola, and so out of these, I mean parabola, circle, ellipse, particular case of circle, ellipse, circle, and hyperbola. So what we will observe that in case del is non-zero, so obviously it will be either parabola or among these three one. So in that case, we will here learn that a different technique for tracing parabola and a similar technique for tracing all these, I mean circle, ellipse or hyperbola, apart from what we have studied in our plus two exam and plus two books. So because see, if this xy term get removed, then you can easily factorize, and by comparing with the standard equation format x square plus a square plus y square p square equal to 1, you can say that it is ellipse, or y square is equal to 4ax, or x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to 1, that it is an ellipse. Or you can write in terms of eccentricity and from there you can observe. But what will happen if xy term is present there? I mean, I will also tell you the technique how to rotate your axis such that this xy term get removed. So that is one of the technique. And once you remove xy term by rotating your axis with a particular angle, by what angle that rotation should be done, that I will explain before curve tracing. But suppose your xy term is present and you cannot factorize it with the help of, I mean in x and y, then in that case we will use some other technique of curve tracing when xy terms are involved. So that is what your chapter 3, and then we will come to polar equation of conic in chapter 4. So these two topic I need to cover. Polar equation, I mean in terms of cos theta. See, till now we have done the Cartesian. In everywhere we are writing in terms of x and y. So that is called Cartesian system. So one is that, in Cartesian system you will find that if we have origin here, then on this right side x will start increasing, and here this is about assumption we have, and on left x will start decreasing. I mean, to the left of origin, we are assuming real numbers to be negative, and on the right as positive, and similarly along this one, y and c, y. So this is the notation for Cartesian. But in polar, this is not. In polar, there is a different concept. I mean, when r is negative, when r is positive, and when theta is negative, when theta is positive. So before starting that, I will make you clear that how to identify, because most of the people are confused here. I mean, if you look at, so you need to understand before starting that, see, theta equal to pi by 2 in polar system. Koi bata sakte hai kiska equation hai? Theta equal to pi by 2. This is the equation of a line. And before this, you need to understand properly where the radius vector r is positive, negative, what is the bounding angle, all that concept. And then we will come to the general equation of, I mean, this equation when transformed into polar form. So there the role of origin is played by pole, and the angle we measured from the initial line. So in that, I mean, in polar equation of conic, what will be the standard equation of circle? What will be the standard equation of line? First, you need to know that. What will happen if your pole is at center of the circle? What will happen if your pole is at the, I mean, boundary of the circle? What will happen if your pole is outside the circle? So all that equation you must know. And from there, we will come to polar equation of conic, that is L by R is equal to 1 plus E cos theta, the standard equation. Where is the eccentricity? So this is what, if you transform this equation under substitution, this you will get this equation L by R equal to 1 plus E cos theta. ठीक है ना, तो ये चीजें आपको पढ़नी है। ये मैं क्यों बता रहा हूँ, क्योंकि ये चीज आपके लिए नहीं है यहाँ पे 11 12th में, तो ये सब आप पैराबोला एलिप्स हाइपरबोला सब बहुत कुछ डिटेल में पढ़ के आए हो। तो लेकिन यहाँ पे ये एक ट्रेसिंग, क्योंकि आपके बुक में जो ट्रेसिंग ये दिस वन इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट यू हैव स्टडीड देयर। ठीक है ना, डिफरेंस समझ आया कि एक्स वाई का टर्म जब मौजूद है तब कैसे ट्रेसिंग करेंगे विदाउट रिमूविंग द एक्स वाई टर्म, दोनों टेक्निक सीखेंगे। And then I will come to polar equation of conic. अब देखो इसमें इसकी क्यों जरूरत होती है, क्योंकि जैसे circle का polar equation of circle का polar equation, ठीक है, तो अगर उसका देखोगे तो उसमें pole अगर origin पे होगा, pole अगर इसके circumference पे होगा, या pole कहीं बाहर है ना, मान लो initial line पे, या pole कहीं नीचे है या कहीं ऊपर है, तो equation कैसे transform होगा, ये सब समझना जरूरी है। एक बार आप ये जानोगे तो polar equation में फिर कुछ बचता नहीं है, बहुत आसान है। टेक्निक सेम है वही सब जो आप कार्टेशियन में पढ़ के आ रहे हो, एक्सेस के, आई मीन जैसे पोलर से कार्टेशियन में भी जा सकते, कार्टेशियन से पोलर में भी जा सकते, वो क्या अंडर व्हाट कंडीशन यू मूव कार्टेशियन इनटू पोलर, पोलर टू कार्टेशियन, वो समय बताऊंगा। ये आपको ये दो टॉपिक रह गया जिसको हमें प्रेफरेंस पे रखना है, और उसके बाद अगर टाइम मिल गया, डेट एक्सटेंड होता है, तो फिर मैं इधर बेसिक जो है सर्कल एलिप्स हाइपरबोला कुछ स्टैंडर्ड इक्वेशन, कुछ स्टैंडर्ड केसेस स्पेशली रेक्टेंगुलर हाइपरबोला वगैरह केस कंजुगेट हाइपरबोला और इन सब का केस करा दूंगा, एसिम्प्टोट्स का और कॉन्सेप्ट, और देखते हैं और क्या है सिलेबस में। ठीक है, तो मेरी नेक्स्ट क्लास है, मैं यहीं पे क्लास से एंड करता हूँ।
ओके सर।
और अभी आप उसके लिए नहीं घबराएंगे, वो जो मैं अभी होम असाइनमेंट दूंगा ना, जो ये, तो मैं गूगल क्लासरूम बना के आपको कोड दे दूंगा। ठीक है, अभी जो पहले दे रहा हूँ ये समझें, इस पे फोकस करना।
सेमेस्टर का पेपर कैसे होगा, ऑनलाइन होगा?
ठीक।